Our Father, as we open Thy Word to study today, direct us by the Spirit of God. Give unto us, our Father, the message that we should deliver, and we'll be glad we did deliver when we stand before God to receive the reward for our stewardship. We ask it in Jesus' name, claiming the victory through His shed blood and for His glory. Amen. Now, we're continuing today our study of the book of Ephesians. We're using as our text the little two-letter word, A-double-L, all. Now, yesterday we talked about the first one. I trust today we'll get more than one, but if we do not, it's all right. We're going to continue the study until we complete the book. Now, yesterday I read three verses, and I read these words. I read beginning with verse 1. I was beginning there with verse 3. But verse 1, Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ with the will of God, to the saints which are at Ephesus, and to the faithful in Christ Jesus, the faithful in Christ. Not to the faithful in religion, but the faithful in Christ. Now, grace be to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. Now, the church is a heavenly people. Our head is in heaven. Our foundation is in heaven. Our citizenship is in heaven. Our conversation is in heaven. We are strangers. We're pilgrims in a strange land. We, who are born of the Spirit, are members of the body of Christ. Now let's continue. The second one. The first all is all spiritual blessings. Yesterday, I said in all love and tenderness, if you have had 10,000 spiritual blessings, if you've had 10,000 spiritual blessings, they all came through Jesus, by Jesus, in Jesus, and of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now verse 4, according as He hath chosen us in Him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before Him in love. Now, we'll talk about that later, but I'm discussing the alls now, and we're coming back later, and we'll discuss these verses. Having predestinated us, the adoption of the children of Jesus Christ to Himself according to the good praise of His will. Yes, I believe in predestination and adoption and the sovereignty of God. Sure, I believe all that. We'll come back to it later. Now, to the praise and the glory of His grace, wherein He hath made us accepted in the Beloved. Now, there are rich things in here, but I want you to see the all. In whom, now here are two verses, in whom we have redemption through His blood. Now get this. Redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of His grace, wherein He hath abounded toward us in all wisdom and prudence. All wisdom. Notice it. All spiritual blessings. And number two is all wisdom. Now let me say this. Let me say this. And please, if you forget everything else I say on this broadcast, don't you miss this. It took all the wisdom of God. Let me put it this way. It took nothing short of the wisdom of Almighty God to think and to provide and to present salvation by the grace of God to man. Now, in other words, Jesus Christ, all wisdom is revealed. All wisdom. All. That is the climax of all wisdom. All wisdom is revealed in the giving of His love, God's love, according to the riches of His grace. All wisdom is wrapped up in the grace of God. Now let me show you what I mean. You remember back yonder in the Garden of Eden, you remember the account. Of course, you were not there, but you remember the account of Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden. All right, God told Adam exactly what to do. Adam knew what to do. Adam knew what to do, and Adam knew what not to do. God instructed him simply and plainly, and there was no excuse for Adam disobeying God. You know that. God told him what to eat, and God marked off what not to eat. But Adam deliberately listened to his wife. His wife listened to the devil, and therefore Adam sinned. Now then, what happened? What happened? Adam put his brain into operation. You know, the devil told Eve that she'd be as gods. They would be as gods, knowing good and evil. All right? They ate the forbidden fruit. They ate of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. They ate. what God told them not to eat. Their eyes were open. They saw their nakedness. What did they do? They set about to, they put their wisdom, their brains, their thinking into operation, and they decided they would correct the mistake. But they didn't correct it. They didn't correct it. They worked mighty hard. I imagine it took quite a few minutes to pick enough fig leaves to make two aprons to cover two naked bodies. I imagine they were quite tired. Their hands, you know, they hadn't been accustomed to picking fig leaves. So I guess they were a little bit tired, and it took quite a bit of time to pick fig leaves and sew them together and make aprons and wrap themselves up. Oh, yes, they put their brains into operation. They used all the wisdom. They exhausted their wisdom. But, beloved, the wisdom of man could not think or provide a covering for sin. No, sir. No, sir. Adam's excuses, his ability, his work, all that he did, all that he thought, all that he wrought was in vain. You know it as well as I know it. But Adam's great-great-great-great-grandsons are still at it. Oh, yes. Ever so often you hear of a new religion. They've got a slant on it that nobody else has. This is it. Oh, yes. This is it. Mm-hmm. Everybody that didn't do it this way has gone to hell. Everybody that doesn't do it this way will go to hell. This is it. You must do this. You must do that. You must do it this way. You can't do it that way. This is it, they say. And so man's wisdom and man's brains and man's ideas. And let me say this. Man has never done anything. Man has never wrought anything. Man has never thought anything that has helped God's redemption. Now you mark that down. God Almighty finished that. And man can't add one single solitary thing to it. And I'm glad he can't. Man may mar and scar up the beautiful forest and the hillsides. And you know, listen, you don't know the beauty of this old earth till you go way back in the jungles of Africa. Where man has never been. Now, I had the privilege. I don't know why God ever gave this poor, ignorant country boy. And that's what I am, just a poor country boy. Didn't have much schooling, thank God for what it did, but did get, but didn't have much. Not a brain, no, but thank God I'm a son of God, I'm born again. But I had the privilege of going way, 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 way back in the jungles of French Equatorial Africa. Back in French Gabon. And the missionary and some pygmies carried us where no white man had ever been. So far as white men know, no white man had ever been there. And those pygmies took their machetes, great big 24-inch long butcher knives, machete, and cut the vines and made a path, and we followed along. Now, brother, you talk about beauty. You talk about beautiful flowers and beautiful trees and beautiful vines and beautiful birds and beautiful butterflies. Now, we saw them. Now, man, everywhere man goes, he talks about beautifying, but he doesn't beautify. He mars and scars and destroys and tears up and tears down. You know that. But listen, there's one thing, thank God, man cannot mar, scar, and tear down. Oh, he tries. And everything he does, God bless your soul, he's never added one thing to God's salvation. He can't change it. He can't rearrange it. It's God's finished product. God Almighty thought it. God Almighty wrought it. Jesus Christ brought it. And his blood bought it, and man can't touch it. Hallelujah to God. Now listen, all wisdom, the height and the depth and the length and the breadth of wisdom, all wisdom is wrapped up in the grace of God. Now listen, we love folks who love us. Oh yes, I know we love our enemies, yes. But I challenge you to get off in the dark and ask yourself just how deeply do you love your enemies. Now, I don't believe there's a man or a woman on this earth that I wouldn't be a friend to. If they needed a friend, I'd befriend them. I would. I'd give them a cup of water, or bless the Lord, I'd divide the last dime I had on this earth with them if they were hungry. But I wonder just how deeply I love my enemies. I wonder just how far I'd go in loving them. Oh, I'd feed them, sure. I'd feed anybody's hungry. I don't care, bless your heart, who they were, nor where they come from, nor what they'd done to me. If they were hungry, I'd feed them. And if they were naked, I'd give them some clothes. If I had any to give them, I'd share my clothes with them. But I wonder if there's anybody on this earth that I love enough to die in their stead. I wonder if there's anybody that I love enough to let my blood trickle down my arms and feet and drip from my body for my enemies. Now, that's what the grace of God did. Now, verse 7, in whom? In whom? Now, remember, in Jesus, in Christ, in Christ. Let that grind into your head and get down in your heart. In Christ, Christ in you, you in Christ, all spiritual blessings in Christ. God hath made Christ wisdom, righteousness, sanctification, redemption. There is therefore now no condemnation of them who are in Christ Jesus. Christ in you, the hope of glory. And therefore, if any man be in Christ Jesus, he's a new creation. We're all baptized by one Spirit into one body. And we've all been made to drink into one Spirit, whether we're Jews or Gentiles, whether we be born or free. Now it's Christ, it's Christ. Listen, in whom we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins. In whom we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of His grace. According to the riches of His grace, wherein He hath abounded toward us in all wisdom. In all wisdom. Listen, we have redemption through His blood. Baptism won't redeem you. Church membership won't redeem you. Clean living won't redeem you. Giving your money to the church will not redeem you. Your good works, your good thoughts, your good deeds, your good actions, your clean living, there's not one single solitary thing that you can do that will redeem you. It takes the shed blood of Jesus, the marvelous grace of God, and it took all of God's wisdom to provide that redemption. Nobody but God Almighty could have ever thought of letting the Son of God die on a cross for wicked, ungodly sinners. Who could have thought of it but God? Who would have permitted it but God? Who? No one could have ever loved like God loved. Now, let's read on a little bit further. Listen. Having made known unto us the mystery of His will, according to His good pleasure, which He hath purposed in Himself. Now, get it. That in the dispensation of the fullness of times. Who said the Bible's not a book of dispensational truth? I've received some of the nastiest letters about the Scofield Bible that I've ever received. Listen, I want you to understand and get it straight. I worship no man, but I thank God for men, old-time saints of God, that burned their lives out studying this Bible, digging into the deep things of God. And they left references, and they spent their life looking through the Scriptures and finding these different verses here and there that have to do with other great truths. And they left them in these Bibles in the form of footnotes and references. And thank God you and I can profit from their life of study. You say what you want to about the Scofield Bible. You go ahead, and the only reason some people hate it and despise it, it's because it dials their number every time they read it, and they get mad and they can't stand it. That's all. That's all. Listen, I have a Scofield Bible in my hand. I got 25 stacked back. Yes, sir. I mean to use it till I die. If I live and preach the gospel 25 more years, I have one for every year for the next 25. I'm not worried. Go ahead, brother. Revise them. Change them. Rearrange them. God bless you. I have mine tucked back. Amen. One fellow wrote me a letter and said, preacher, you better wrap those Bibles up real good. They'll spoil. No, sir, thank God. No, they're all right. They'll keep. Amen. I got them, brother. They're back. Go ahead and do all you want to do. Just go ahead. I have mine tucked away. Now, I feel sorry. I wish right now if somebody dumped $1 million in my lap and said, preacher, do what you want to with it. I'd go to the radio today. I wouldn't wait till tomorrow. I would today. I'd make an announcement that I'd be glad to give everybody, write me a letter. I'd give them a Scofield Bible. I wish I could. I can't. It would be impossible, utterly impossible. But if I had the money, I'd give every person listening to my voice who does not have a Scofield Bible, I'd give you one if I were able. I'm not. I wish I was. But let me say this. The Bible is a book of dispensational truth. God deals in dispensations. Yes, He does. You can't get around it. You cannot. So, He said that in the dispensation of the fullness of times, He might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on the earth, even in Him. Now, we have to stop right there. In the dispensation of the fullness of times, He might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth. Now, some time ago, I delivered a series of sermons on the return of Jesus, and I said that the second coming of Jesus Christ is necessary. It's necessary to unite the saints of God. Now listen, part of the saints of God are in paradise resting with Jesus right now. That's what the Bible teaches. Absent from the body, present with the Lord. Amen. Absent from the body, present with the Lord. Hallelujah. Doesn't mean it's what people say. Read the book. I read the book. I read the Bible. I thank God for preachers. I thank God for teachers. But I take the Word of God as my final authority. Now then, so one of these days, and this is the dispensation of the full time. This is the last dealing. That is, now I don't mean that this is the last time that anybody will ever be saved. But the church age is God's great day of grace when God is calling out peoples, Jews, Gentiles, rich, poor, bond, free. Makes no difference the color of your skin, your nationality. Doesn't make difference. Jesus will save you if you'll let Him. Now, this is that day, great day of grace, all right? Now, in the end of this dispensation, Jesus will come back to this earth, and every born-again child of God will be caught up, will be changed in a moment in the twinkling of an eye, and will be caught up to meet Jesus in the air. Now, all the saints that have died and will die up to the rapture, all those saints will be resting with Jesus. He'll bring those saints with Him in the air, and we who are alive will be caught up to meet the Lord Jesus in the air. Then we will all be united in Him. All things in earth and all things in heaven will all be united in Jesus. Now, it is the plan of God to have one great family, and that will take place when Jesus comes again. But now listen, only those who have been redeemed by His blood. Redemption comes by the blood. Redemption is in His blood, and Christ in you is the only hope of glory. And if Christ is in you, then you are a member of His church. The Lord added to the church daily such as were being saved. Acts 2:47. The Lord added to the church daily. Now, the only way you can become a member of the church that will be raptured out of this earth is through the redeeming blood of Jesus Christ. His redeeming blood. If you're under the blood, if you're in Christ, if you're redeemed by the blood, you'll be caught up when all things in heaven and all things in earth are united in Jesus in the air. Now, if you're not under the blood, if you're not in Jesus, you're lost, and you'll be left to go through the terrible, horrible tribulation period. If you're not saved, bow your head, shut your eyes, and ask God to have mercy on you right now. And He will. He'll wash your sins away, and He'll give you the blessed assurance that you're prepared to meet God. Father, in the name of Jesus, honor Thy precious word, honor the blood of Jesus, and may this be the day that some sinner will be redeemed by His precious blood. Save many souls, save those who are under conviction now, and we'll give God the praise. We claim the victory in the saving name of Jesus, and for His sake we ask it. Amen.